If you need to record your voice or instrument and add effects like reverb or delay, there's some free software called Audacity that you might want to check out. We're going to show you exactly how to use it so you don't have to waste your time trying to figure it out on your own. Hey everyone, Transverse Audio here. To put it bluntly, Audacity is a free tool for recording and manipulating audio. First, let's go over the interface and the setup needed. The first thing you want to do is either record using this button here, or import the audio you want to work with by going to File, then down to Import and select Audio. You can also drag and drop files directly into Audacity, which may make it a bit easier for you. Before you start recording, you'll want to make sure your inputs are right. Here you can select what device you'll record with, and next to it you can choose to record in mono or stereo. You can also select what device you plan on listening with. Right above them, you'll find the recording and the playback levels, as well as the volume control for both of them. If you need to record at a specific sample rate, the quickest way to change it is at the bottom toolbar. Now let's move on to editing. To select specific parts of a track, you can click and drag, and to move the start and stop, hover over the regions until you see the pointing hand. You can double-click on the waveform, or click once on the left menu to select the entire track. With your selection, you can perform the typical actions such as copy, paste, delete, etc. When you hit record, each track will play as well, unless it's muted. This is perfect if you need to listen to an instrumental while you sing, or if you plan on playing all of the instruments yourself in a song and need to stay in sync. Audacity also comes with a lot of effects to use. With this many effects to play with, you're bound to find what you need, from delay and reverb to pitch shifting and phase. You can also apply an EQ and a compressor to your tracks for further refinement. Exporting is the final stage to our journey in Audacity. When you've recorded, edited, and polished your production, it's time to wrap it up. Go up to File, and under Import, you'll find the export options. Select your file name, location, etc., and you're done. Now that you have a basic understanding of Audacity, getting your voiceovers, instrumentals, or really any recording down and polished should be a breeze. If you like what you've seen, subscribe for more. And as always, thanks for watching.